me. My name is Marcus Orton. I've actually was one of the first builders in Mogul Nation. It's kind of funny how we got started, but just a little background on myself. I actually been on and off in the industry probably about maybe 10 years now. I had some success. I've had some ups, I had some downs. You know what I'm saying? I actually work full-time as a business consultant. I'm actually connected to a lot of people in the industry, which is how I am able to get what they call access, the privilege to share information that I've learned from the great. So once again, I'm not going to talk too much about myself. I definitely want to give it back up to all of the leadership on the team. And does anyone know what today is? Drop in the chat if you know what today is. Drop it in the chat. Let's see who can get it right first. What is today? What is today? Who's going to get it right first? I bet you if I put it, I'm going to give you a cash app. Okay. Somebody said payday. Oh, who was that got it right first? That was Tony, residual day. Can we get a happy residual day, everybody? Happy residual day. For those who are new that may not know what residual is, residual is when you get paid over and over again for doing something one time. So in school, they teach you, they teach you how to be very good at helping somebody else build their sandcastle on the beach. I'm just telling you how it is. It's the truth. We all go to the beach. There's sand everywhere. There's ocean and there's sand everywhere. But most people will choose to go to the beach and help somebody else build their sandcastle when they could have built their own themselves. So, about this whole sandcastle thing, it's great. You can help somebody else build their sandcastle. It's infinity. It's a bunch of sand out here. You can help somebody else build their sandcastle. They're going to pay you $10 an hour, $20 an hour, $50 an hour, whatever, 401k benefits. But just understand that you're going to have to ask when you want time off. So what residual is when you actually do something one time, get paid over and over again so that you can live life on your terms and not somebody else's terms. Can I get a residual in the chat? Who's looking for some more residuals? Who want more residuals? Drop a residual in the chat if you're looking for more residuals every Friday. Oh, by the way, we do get paid every Friday for those who are new. We get paid every Friday. Listen, I'm not going to talk too long. We got a super, I told you we got some thunder and lightning coming tonight. But I do want to make sure that I get everything out before I get the thunder and the lightning. I'm just the warm-up guy, okay? I'm just here to warm up the main event, okay? So the next thing I want to talk about is the Mogul Nation Facebook group. All of the updates. We got the Mogul Nation Facebook group is where you're going to see a lot of the updates. So make sure that everyone is in the Mogul Nation Facebook group. And once again, we all know letslaunchyou.com is the first place that you want to get very familiar with when you come on board as a new dealer. Also, one other thing, in Telegram, for those who are in Telegram, which, by the way, everyone should be in our Telegram channel. It would be nice if you could put your dealer ID in your bio. It helps the leaders when we got issues with pay, things of that nature. If you could just put your dealer ID in your bio, it's gonna make things go a lot more smoother. So with that being said, I'm not gonna keep you guys all day. What I wanna get into first is we actually have, can I get a drum? We got two testimonials for you guys right now, right off the top. Can I get a drum roll, please? Drum roll. Matter of fact, drop a who in the chat, which stands for who is it? Who is it that we got a testimonial? Just go ahead and drop a who in the chat while we going to go ahead and announce our first. Is it a, what we got a promotion here? We got a promotion. I mean, just make sure it is a promotion. I want to go ahead and shout out Mr. Adam Smith. Adam Smith, can everybody get a...
Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Work so hard, got hard to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hate and say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
All right. Definitely want to give it up to Mr. Adam Smith. Shout him out on your social media pages. Tag him on it. You always want to build each other up. You always want to appreciate those that come before you and after you. So definitely want to give it up to Mr. Adam Smith. And the next person that we have, this person right here, man, he came through at the last minute, but I knew it was another person. But we had to give him a shout out, okay? This next person, he does have a testimonial, I believe. I'm going to go ahead and bring on Mr. Oliver Lewis.
And I know I sound dramatic, yeah, but I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bad, yeah. But they didn't know me last year.
Can we bring Mr. Oliver Lewis up with his testimonial? I see Oliver there. Oliver, we can't hear you, but just unmute your line so everyone can hear you. Hey, guys.
Can you hear me now?
All right, we can hear you. Go ahead, take it away, boss.
Awesome. First of all, I want to give it back to you, Marcus Holton. Thank you. And second of all, I want to give it back to first. No, I'm sorry. First of all, I want to give it back to my mentor, Carolyn's Cassius. This guy is phenomenal. This guy is. I want to say thank you for my first promotion as WB 100. This guy called me every day just to motivate me and giving me like the right spirit to get promoted. I could have done it. I could have get promoted earlier. I got promoted less than a month. I could have done it earlier because of his energy and his spirit. And guys, I got promoted because of him. So that's the only thing I wanted to share with you guys. And I wanted to tell the team, thank you. Thank you, Carolyn. Thank you, man. Like, stay the leader as you are. And we're gonna grow, and I appreciate you for everything, and let's go. Appreciate you guys.
I believe we have another testimonial. Mr. Adam Smith, newly promoted WB 100. Is he on the line? Can we get a testimonial?
I'm right here. Can you hear me?
Adam on the line.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, sir.
I thought you forgot about me, man. You called my name first, went to the next guy. I got a little nervous, man.
We got you,
But I appreciate the love and support from everybody. Well, yeah, man, I like to keep things very short and brief. I've only been with the program about a week. I got promoted within a week. I want to do a big shout out to my man, Joe Johnson, and also my mentor, Ty, man. So I'm actually out here in Atlanta from Detroit. And I saw the potential in the program mainly because I learned that, hey, these are skill sets that you can actually learn to help other people's lives. So one of the main things that I always push for everybody, that whatever goal that you have or whatever niche that you might have as far as being an entrepreneur, whatever, you got to have a foundation with credit. And that's just been my main thing for everybody that I've talked to. But, you know, I really love the community and support that we have here, man. We got to keep pushing each other. We got to keep being great. I want everybody here to be a Director 10, Director 25. Put them fires in the chats if we going up next week, because we love it. It's residual day today. But next week is going to be even better. Let's get it.
Let's get it.
I got that hit to beat the block. You can get that bass on below. I got that rock and roll. That future flow. That digital spit. Next level visual.
All right. We definitely appreciate your testimonials. Hopefully, we're going to see you way, way at the top, over the top, at the tippy top. And maybe, hopefully, somebody recorded this and we can go back and play this moment when you're at the top. All right. Enough of that. What I want to do now is get ready for some action, some thunder, some lightning. Before I bring up our guest speaker for the night, I just want to just give a little background of how I met this gentleman, okay? You know, we all in the industry, we all in network marketing, we all get approached, you know, that's something that we do on a regular basis. It's our industry, it's the nature, it's a people business, network marketing. It's all about people, right? So when this young man reached out to me, he actually reached out to me in my DM on Facebook. The first thing I said was, wait a minute, hold on. This guy wasn't trying to pitch me nothing. He wasn't trying to sell nothing. He was so smooth. Like, I immediately Googled him. I was like, I'm gonna Google, who is this guy? It was just too good. Listen, when you're being in the industry or associating yourself with the industry for quite some time, some of us have been here a couple months, some of us have been in the industry for years. You know how it sounds when you're being pitched something. It feels like you're being pitched. And you immediately be like, no, I'm not interested. This man came at me so smooth, like, you know how like Bruce Lee would be like, whoa, like, you know, he would be like all perfect with it. And you'd be like, dang, how is he so smooth? And his shoulder would pop. You know what I'm saying? You'd be like, dang. You'd be like, hold on. He immediately got my attention. I'm like, dude, it wasn't even had nothing to do with what he was trying to pitch. It was how well he pitched me. In my mind, I'm thinking, I need to learn what he knows because that was too good. It was just way too good. So anyway, make a long story short, you know, we got connected. And before I even get into who the guy is, I didn't know who he was. I didn't know. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't know. I knew, but I didn't know. If anybody did that, I don't even know if that even makes sense. But listen, all I got to say is this. This man told me, jump on board. We're going to start running with this thing, which we did. His method of duplication was ridiculous, dude. I was like, dude, this cannot be. Make a long story short, I could go in all day on that experience. But let me just tell you who this guy is, who I found out that the guy was. The guy has an international network marketing business. And God knows how many countries that he's built. He's a $1 million earner, which means that his business does million, he's made millions of dollars in the industry of network marketing. His business has brought in millions. The guy is him and his wife. Let me tell you something right now. One thing I know is I know good people when I see them, okay? This is a man who I literally partnered with him for like a whole month. We were doing the business. We was doing it, and it was a great, and it was working. But it was just some differences, you know, that we didn't even go. But listen, what he told me, when I told him that I was doing this full time, let me tell you what the man told me. The man told me, you know what? I respect what you're doing. If you need anything with that new thing that you're doing, if you need a call, if you need a training call, you need motivation. I said, what? I said, you gonna do something from me and I'm leaving? Most people would kick you. They don't want to talk to you no more. If they're not getting paid from off of you, they're not trying to do nothing with you. This man is saying, I'm willing to help, even though you listen. That's a good man. That's a good person. That's the type of person that we should be. You should be willing to do something for another person, even though it doesn't really benefit you to do that. Okay. So with that being said, I'm not going to give his whole story. I'm going to let him give his story. But I will tell you this. for those who are been in the network marketing industry, if you know who the man Eric Worre is, how many of y'all know who Eric Worre is? Drop a me in the chat if you know who Eric Worre is. Okay, I see some me's in the chat. I see some me's in the chat. When this man told me that he was good friends with Eric Worre, I immediately stopped everything. I dropped my water. I did. I said, what do you want me to do? How you want me to do it? What I got to do? This man, if you don't know who Eric Worre is, Eric Worre is the author of the GoPro Network Marketing book. The dude is like a straight up guru at network marketing. He's a guy that everybody knows and goes to when they have questions in our industry. And this guy got him on speed dial. With that being said, I would like to introduce and bring up a good friend of mine, million-dollar earner, international network marketer. Can we give, man, drop a fire in the chat, please. Can we drop a fire in the chat? But drop some fire. God, drop some fire in the chat. Drop some fire in the chat for million-dollar earner, Miles Stellar.
Can't stop, won't stop. Yeah.
What's
can't
up, stop, everybody?
Won't stop, never stop. Can't stop, won't stop, never.
Awesome.
Can't stop, won't stop, bad boy. Always upgrading from my last.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Marcus. And I hope everybody is having a fantastic night. I know it's Friday. There's a lot of things that you guys can be doing, but I appreciate that you guys are on here right now. And I respect you and I commend you, first off, for spending your Friday evening on a training call to better your life. Because I think, honestly, the first thing that you should be paying attention to if you want to grow a successful business inside network marketing is sometimes you got to make some sacrifices. And a Friday night not always is an easy sacrifice. So I know a lot of you guys could be doing other things, but you are here now to better your life, better your business, better your family's life, and you know, your future. So I commend you and I congratulate you for that. But Marcus, thank you so much, man. I'm excited to be here with you guys. I'm excited to share some knowledge that I have learned over the last 7 years being involved in the industry. I've got some really, really, really solid content for you guys that if you retain this, not just retain it, not just get this, but you put it into action, it can take your entire business to a whole nother level. So I encourage you, please make sure you have pen and paper out. Make sure you're taking notes. Don't trust your memory. Trust me whenever I tell you that, because I promise you the info and the content that I have for you guys is the content that has made me several million dollars over the last couple of years. And it's also allowed me to help and coach over 150 people to multiple six and seven figures. So the content that I have, y'all, it's real, it's legit, and it's going to take your life to the next level. So make sure your pins are locked and loaded, and we're going to get this party started. So let me go ahead and first off, though, congratulate Oliver and Adam. I know you guys are crushing the business right now. Y'all are both new to the business. So congratulations for making a life-changing decision just by joining the business. But congratulations on hitting that rank, and congratulations on moving forward with this thing. So I just wanted to congratulate you guys, because it's just the beginning, and you guys are in for a long, fun ride that will literally change your life. So moving on, guys, I want to tell y'all a little bit of my story just so we're not strangers. My name is Miles Stallard. I live in the Dallas-Fort Worth area in a small town called Granbury, Texas. It's on the lake out here, Lake Granbury. You may or may not heard of it. If you've heard of it, it's probably because you live here, because if you've never lived here before, you probably never heard of it. Small little town, all right? So I grew up out here. I graduated from North Texas, got my degree in medical rehab. So my whole plan was actually physical therapy. That was the whole reason why I went to school. But then my senior year, I did an internship. I realized physical therapy was literally the very last thing that I wanted to spend the rest of my life doing. Anybody relate to that? Drop a 111 in the chat if you yourself relate to getting your degree, never using it, or maybe you know somebody like that. Honestly, I think it's kind of the world that we live in, right? Like, especially my generation. I'm 31. I started network marketing when I was 24. But my generation, you know, we were raised to believe, you know, go to school, get good grades, go to college, and work a 9-to-5 for 40 years and hopefully retire 40% of your income after you work your entire life, 40 hours a week, right? The 40-40-40 club. I think most of us now, you're in this business because you're probably aware retirement these days, it's fairy tale. You know what I mean? Like, we've got to find plan Bs, man. We got to find other ways, because what used to work does not work anymore. And this is why I'm so passionate about network marketing, by the way, because it has absolutely changed my life, not just because of the network marketing itself, but it has opened so many doors to so many other things that I'm going to share with you guys here in just a second. But anyway, so went to school, got my degree, never used it, went into insurance as a claims adjuster, was crushing it. I was 24. I was already breaking a six-figure income. So I thought I had it figured out. You know, I thought that was going to be my career. I thought that's what I was going to do for the rest of my life. But then I came across a friend of mine who was doing the network marketing industry. He was part of a health and wellness company. He was doing this thing and he was killing it. I mean, he was clearly making millions of dollars. He was traveling all over the world, driving exotic cars. I mean, he was looking better than ever, man. I was just seeing literally this like exotic lifestyle. And it caught me off guard because the last time I spoke to him was only a year before that. And he was not successful at all. Now, all of a sudden, he's like on a whole nother level of success. And I'm like, what in the world is this guy doing? Looked into it, saw it was network marketing. Honestly, at first, I was negative. I was skeptical. I've seen people do network marketing. I've just never seen anybody really have success with network marketing. So when I first saw this, I kind of threw it to the side, had that whole, you know, if it seems too good to be true, probably is. You know, you guys have heard it before. You know, when you're talking about network marketing, multi-level marketing, we've all heard the same excuses or the same rebuttals or the same doubts, whatever, right? We've all heard the same thing. And, but that was me, right? So I kind of threw it aside, didn't think a whole lot about it. Week later, saw his Facebook again. I was like, you know what? I need to hit this guy up. I know him. Like, I'd be stupid not to at least pick his brain. You know what I mean? Like, let's at least see what this industry is all about. And sure enough, I did. He got me in front of a few other people. And I just saw a lot of people winning. You know, I started looking into the industry. I started studying the industry and I figured, okay, I need to give this thing a shot. And I did. And I mean, it was the best decision I've ever made. I've made millions of dollars inside of the industry. Like I said, I've helped over 150 people create multiple six and seven figures within the industry as well. So I'm very passionate from a coaching standpoint, but I'm honestly most passionate about being in the field. I like the trenches. I like being in phase one. I like building. Most people that are building this business, when they get to where I'm at in the business, at the rank that I'm at, the income that I'm at, most people like to sit back, collect the residuals. Me personally, I find a lot of excitement in just being in the trenches. I like the grind. I like the hustle. I like the process. And I do believe if you want to be successful inside of network marketing, step number one is you've got to fall in love with the process. You got to fall in love with the grind. You got to fall in love with the game. So many of us, we don't want to fall in love with the process. We dread the process. We dread the hard part, the challenge. But if you want to be successful, you got to learn, you got to make the decision to fall in love with the process. It's not always going to be easy and it's not always going to be fun, but guess what? You can tell yourself that it's fun. You can tell yourself that it's easy. You can tell yourself that it's worth it. And when you tell yourself and you convince yourself, you got to learn to brainwash yourself sometimes. If you want to be successful, you've got to brainwash yourself into believing the things that you're not necessarily feeling. See, so many of us, we want to be motivated before we go into action. We want to be motivated before we do anything, right? But here's the reality. You can't wait to be motivated to take the action that you know is necessary. You have to act your way into the motivation. You got to act your way into feeling. And this is so freaking true. And I see this all the time, to where people are so hesitant. They're so slow to take the action. They procrastinate over and over and over just simply because they're waiting around to be motivated. The truth be told, you're not ever gonna be motivated. But you will be motivated when you start taking the action. See, this business is fun. Network marketing is fun when you're doing the work, when you're taking the action. Because when you're taking the action, you're doing the work, you're giving yourself a sense of hope. When you're not doing the work, this is when the business can get challenging. This is when it gets stressful. Because if you're not doing the work, you know, subconsciously, you know that you're not going to get the results that you need. But when you're taking the action, even if you're not getting the results right there, if you're taking the action, you know that eventually you are going to get those results. Something that I've always said, better than the feeling of victory is the feeling of effort. Knowing that because You worked your ass off. Part of my language, I don't know if I'm allowed to cuss, but I'm going to say it anyway. But because you worked your ass off, you know that is why you have had success. Better than the feeling of victory is the feeling of effort. Laying your head down at night knowing that you gave it your all. You need to make sure, too, every single night that you go to bed, you need to ask yourself, would I have hired myself today or would I have fired myself today if I was my boss? What would I have done? Would I hire somebody that did the work that I did today, or would I have fired somebody because they didn't do the work that I was supposed to do today? Anyway, so going back to my story, because I kind of got sidetracked there. But anyways, got into the industry. It's allowed me to do a lot of things. Obviously, with the financial means that it's blessed me with, I'm now a venture capitalist. I'm an angel investor. So I get to invest in startups, established businesses, real estate. I have my hands in stocks. I have my hands in crypto. I have my hands really in anything and everything that can create what you heard today from Marcus, passive residual income. I'm crazy passionate about it. And so I kind of have my hands in anything and everything. But again, it's because of this industry. And this is also why I love network marketing so much, because again, it can open so many doors. And again, it's not just the business models. It's not just the products inside of the industry. It's the people you meet. It's the network. It's the relationships you build. And it's the skills that you learn. Like the doors that this industry can open for any of us is, I mean, you literally cannot put a price tag on that. So let me go ahead and dive into my training though, okay? Because I don't know how much time I have. I've already gotten a little bit long-winded. But again, like I said, I got a lot of good content for you guys. So I've got a list here, okay? Technically, I have a training. I call it Check 22. It's 22 things, but kind of condensed it into technically 14 things. But I'm probably not going to go into all 14 because I'm going to kind of like combine them anyways because I know I'm running low on time. But the first thing that I want you guys to know, if you want to be successful, if you want to be successful in anything in life, okay, number one is you have got to learn to get out of your comfort zone. The only thing that's going to hold you back is your comfort zone. You've got to get comfortable being uncomfortable. I'm sure you guys have heard this before. You've heard it said like that before, but I really want you to meditate on this. I really want you to marinate this, because the truth is, if you can't learn to get out of your comfort zone, you're never going to do the things that you know you need to do. See, a lot of you guys on here right now, you are not at all where you want to be in the business. But the truth is, you're not where you want to be, not because you don't know what to do, not because you don't have the skill sets, but it's because you're scared to do what you know you have to do. You're scared to make the phone calls. You're scared to make the contact. You're scared to get the no's. You're scared of the rejection. And maybe you're not scared, but it's just a little bit uncomfortable. Maybe the comfort zone is not necessarily being scared of something, but maybe it's because you work a 9-to-5. So you don't have all the hours in the day. So you're tired. You're exhausted. But your comfort zone is not allowing you to get up earlier or stay up later. See, a lot of us get this whole comfort zone, you know, we kind of funnel it into and focus it in on, you know, talking to people, because truth be told, that's one of the biggest fears people have is public speaking, and not just public speaking, but talking to strangers, talking to people that you don't know. Believe it or not, I am an incredibly introverted person, incredibly introverted. You know, this is something I was talking to Eric about, Eric Worry, and I don't know if you guys may or may not have seen me on a bunch of his platforms. I've been on, you know, all of his interview stuff. I've been on a couple of things with his, but he is a close friend of mine, and we were talking about introvert versus extrovert. And truth is too, Eric, by the way, is a very introverted person as well. I changed my major, by the way, in college, my sophomore year in college, I changed my major from marketing to medical rehab simply because I was scared to do a 1-minute speech in front of 8 people. And it wasn't even 1 minute, it was a 1-minute max. All I had to do is say who I was, where I was from, and what my major was. I was terrified. I literally went to the counselors, changed my major right there. I said, put me into whatever category that I need to be in where I don't have to speak in front of people. I don't have to take a speech class. And that was medical rehab. And I was like, okay, physical therapy, I can go down that route. I like sports. I like, you know, body movement, stuff like that. That could work. Let's do it, right? And sure enough, that was not a good move. Marketing probably would have been better, especially for what I do now. But anyways, it was this industry, by the way, that changed that. because it was about 2 weeks into network marketing. My mentor made me do my first presentation in front of about 25 people. And it was live as in front of everybody. And he said, hey, you're doing the presentation today, or you're doing the front half of the presentation. And I said, absolutely no way. No, I'm not. I'll leave. He says, if you don't do the presentation, I'm leaving. There's 25 people here waiting to hear this presentation. These are all your guests. This is your business. I think it'd be wise of you to do the front half of the presentation. Okay, fair enough. I did the front half of the presentation. There's a photo of it. My mom was there. My mom was super embarrassed for me. It was the worst presentation on the planet. My arms were crossed. My back was towards the audience. I was looking at the screen, and I was literally just reading the slides so freaking fast. Nobody understood me. I was jumping over my words. I was literally like blacking out. I was sweating. It was miserable, absolutely miserable. But it was that moment that I went from being okay and settling for mediocrity to saying, you know what, I'm going to do this thing and I'm going to do it right. I went home. I literally stood in front of the mirror. This is no joke. I had my wife's brush. We were actually just dating at the time, but I had her hairbrush. I pretended like it was a mic for hours. I sat there and I did the presentation over and over and over and over. By the way, you might be saying to yourself, I'll never do a presentation. I'll never public speak. Here's the deal. You can do whatever you want. Okay. And by the way, there's a lot of leaders on here. I'm speaking to a lot of team members of other leaders. If I say something that goes against what you are being taught, don't like disregard your leader. Your leader is your leader. Follow the same system. Every company is different. Every company builds different. Every network marketing, everything about network marketing it has to be catered and it has to be tailored to specific companies. So if something doesn't work, don't necessarily just say, oh, Miles said it, I'm going to go do what he said instead of follow the system. Because honestly, nothing beats the system. Follow the system. However, I will say, if you say you're never going to do a presentation, fine, you don't have to. If you want to be successful, you need to learn the presentation as if you are going to present it tomorrow. For a lot of different reasons, not because you might not ever have to do a presentation. That's fine. However, learning the presentation as if you're going to have to present it will bring out a whole nother level of confidence when you're talking to people about your opportunity. There is so much power behind knowing the presentation, not just knowing the information, but being able to be confident in the words that you speak. Because again, it's not what you say to somebody about your opportunity that's going to bring them in, how it's going to recruit them, whatever it may be. It's how you say it. It's your conviction. It's your confidence. That's what sells. See, people will follow strength. They're not going to follow somebody that is weak, that is hesitant, that's unsure. See, a lot of you guys go into conversations when you're talking about your opportunity and you're hesitant. You're slow to speak. You're weak in your posture. Therefore, they don't want to follow you. Why would anybody want to follow somebody that's not even sure about it themselves? See, people have to trust that you can take them where they need to be. And keep in mind, network marketing, y'all, this is a partnership business. It's a partnership. So if people have to want to be your business partner. So you've got to represent that. You've got to be that for that person. So again, that was only my first point. I got like 14 others, so I got to speed up. I get long-winded. I told Marcus this, man. I said, listen, man, dude, I was like, you know what? I might do a Q&A. You ask me a question, you can say, how old are you? I promise you I can talk for 30 minutes. And again, I'm introverted, but learning to get out of your comfort zone will change everything for you. And to be honest with you, I still get very uncomfortable doing Zooms, doing presentations. Y'all, I've spoken on stages with tens of thousands of people. I've shared the stage with some of the most elite entrepreneurs in the world, and I still do not like it. However, I choose to like it. I make the decision to like it. I make the decision to, instead of being nervous, instead of being fearful, being excited. See, being nervous and being excited, I don't know if you guys know this, is really interesting. I learned this not too long ago, but being nervous and being excited is the exact same thing, the same thing, the same hormones, the same thing is going on in your body, being nervous and being excited. It's simply your mindset. What are you thinking? Am I nervous or am I excited? So next time you're like nervous, I'm nervous to do this presentation, I'm nervous to talk to this person, flip that. It's simply flipping the switch and saying, you know, I'm not nervous. I'm excited. I'm fired up. Do whatever you got to do to get excited. It'll change everything. So get out of your comfort zone. Okay, next thing, stop procrastinating. I already talked about this a little bit. Stop procrastinating. Okay, one of my mentors, multi-billion-dollar mentor, he I was in Tokyo with him. I was speaking on a training, network marketing. You get it. Anyways, I was in Tokyo. I was on stage. Anyways, I was with him, and we were going out to dinner. And we're in, I don't know if you guys have ever been to Tokyo before, but Japan is like much more advanced than the United States, believe it or not. I did not know that until I got there. And I was like, holy smokes, like this place is like on a whole nother level. And anyway, so we're there, we're in this really nice, like luxury taxi van thing, which by the way, is completely beside the point, it has nothing to do with the story, but I just painting the picture of Tokyo for you. Anyway, so we're in the car and I'm with him. His name's Kirk Hansen. He actually passed away 2 years ago, plane crash. Again, beside the point, but a good mentor of mine, somebody that I look up to greatly. And anyways, so he is the, his family now owns the largest privately owned gas and oil distribution center in the entire United States. Okay, so big time money. Anyway, so I'm with him. We're going to dinner. We're going to the sushi place. And he's talking about all the stuff that he's got to get done, right? And he's getting phone calls. He's getting emails. You know, he's working in the car. He's still talking to me. We're still having a conversation. And it was so crazy because he's like, hey, I got to do this. I got to do this. I got to do this, right? And I'm thinking, okay, so he's like making a list of what he's got to do whenever he gets back to his hotel room, maybe what he's got to do when he gets back to the States. Like, you know, he's making this list, right? And before we even get there, all of the stuff that he was talking about, how he had to get done, he got done like then and there. And I was like, and it was kind of like, okay, procrastination, I understand this, but then it kind of clicked because even though he is literally probably the busiest human I've ever met in my entire life, he still had more time to do the things that he wanted to do with his family, with his kids, with his church. Like see, procrastination is it's a liar. It's a thief of opportunity. Okay. But it makes you think that if I procrastinate now, if I put it off now, I'm going to have more time later. The reality is procrastination steals your time. John Maxwell, you guys probably know who John Maxwell is, but he talks about this in one of his books. He says, you know what? What you need to do if you struggle with procrastination, which all of us do, I still to this day struggle with procrastination. However, it's something that is on the forefront of my mind that I'm always reminding myself about. And this is what you got to be really good at as well, is you need to make sure that you're aware. See, awareness is the key. As long as you're aware of it, you can fix it. If you're not aware of it, you can't fix it. But you got to be aware of it. And this is what John Maxwell teaches, says every morning when you wake up, say, do it now, do it now, do it now. Say it 50 times. And then before you go to bed, say, do it now, do it now, do it now 50 times. Now you might be saying, okay, do it now 50 times. Like that seems like it'd be a lot of work. It's really not. Do it now, 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 do it now. That was 10 right there. You can literally say, do it now in like less than 30 seconds, 50 times. Okay. But do it and do it now, right? So do it now 50 times before you go to bed, 50 times whenever you wake up. It's going to program your subconscious mind to do it now. Stop putting things off. Do it now. I'm sure a lot of you guys, you know, when you're in school, high school, college, whatever it may be, a professor, a teacher says, hey, we're going to have a test on Friday. What did I do? Every single test, I never studied until I got to the classroom the day of the test. As soon as I got there, I'm like cramming everything that I can. I'm asking everybody, okay, do y'all have the answers? You have like, what's this, right? That's how I literally operated. I will never forget the one time in college, the professor said, hey, we have a test on Friday, and it was Monday, and I actually studied, and I was so prepared for that test literally before Tuesday. And I was like, wow, life would be a whole lot easier if I didn't just do this every single time I had a test. And I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate to that. Some of y'all are probably like overachievers and y'all are like, I've never waited till last minute to study for a test. Well, I did. And that is the wrong thing to do. So don't procrastinate. Okay. Number three, have a DMO, daily method of operation. Most of you guys have jobs. You are doing this network marketing company to hopefully get out of your job. I get that. However, in order to be successful in this business, you have to make this business a priority. There's a difference between a responsibility and priority. Write this down. A responsibility is something that you have to get done. A priority is something that has to come first. When I was a claims adjuster, I was doing good. I was successful. My job was my responsibility. I had to do my job because that is how I put food on the table. If I didn't do my job, my responsibility was going to sink me. However, my network marketing business was my priority. My job was my responsibility. My network marketing was my priority. You go to your 9 to 5 all day long. Don't forget your 5 to 9. Your 5 to 9 is how you make your fortune. Your 5 to 9 is how you set up your whole family for generations. It's not your 9 to 5, it's your 5 to 9. Okay. So with this, I want to talk about time blocking. This is how I operate every single day. I'm an athlete. I'm sure some of you guys are athletes, whatever it may be. And what I want you to imagine, maybe you're not an athlete, but you know, like, if you guys know who David Goggins is, Navy SEAL, freaking awesome. Read his books. He's a great dude. A lot of my best friends, by the way, they're Navy SEALs. And I love the whole philosophy that David Goggins talks about, you know, and I kind of live my life this way. But imagine you have David Goggins and he's your coach, right? Like, the alarm goes off at 6 a.m. and he is on top of you. He's like, it's time to get out of bed. It's time to take a shower. It's time to brush your teeth. It's time to do this. It's time to do that. It's time to go to your job. It's time to go to the gym now. It's time to work your Kayani business. Time to work your network marketing business. It's time to make the phone calls. It's time to do this. It's time to do that, right? Imagine you have a coach that is telling you what to do, when to do it, how to do it every single second of every single day. My mentor said, Miles, if I was your boss, you would already be making millions of dollars every single month. I thought about this. And I was like, wow, that's so true. Because in network marketing, you don't have a boss. This is a volunteer army. You have to be your own boss. You have to be disciplined being disciplined. This is what I said earlier. You have to ask yourself, would I have hired myself or would I have fired myself? You have to be good at being your own boss. But again, imagine you are being your own boss. How do you become your own boss? This is how I do it. My alarm clock is my boss. And you all heard of time blocking. Every single hour of every single day, Monday through Friday, Saturdays, I kind of give myself a little leeway. Sunday, I take Sundays off because I believe in the Sabbath. But Monday through Friday, every single hour is completely calculated. It is all intentional. I know what I'm doing every single hour of every single day. And I play the game as if I am a machine. And what I mean by this, a machine does what it's supposed to do. Imagine you're driving a car, right? You're driving a car, you're hitting the gas, the car is going. You hit the brake, the car stops. You're driving the car, you steer the car left, it turns left. Steer it right, it turns right. See, a machine does what a machine is told to do. It's perfect. Now imagine you're driving a car and you're hitting the gas, and then all of a sudden you have to hit the brake, and you're hitting the brake and the car doesn't stop and it keeps going. Disaster. You tell it to go left, ends up going right. Disaster, right? See, you have to become a machine. Your alarm clock is your commander. See, if you have a job to do, if you have a job, you're working the 9 to 5, and you only have a small period of time to work your network marketing business, it's not hard to focus on that as long as you are intentional with it. So when the alarm goes off, you do what you said you were going to do. Not a second later, not a second before. You are a machine. You do it when it's told, when it tells you to do it. This is how I operate. This is the game that I play. So the game that I play every single day is beating the alarm. It's mastering the game. It's how good can I fight against time? Because time is everything. If you can beat time, you can beat everything else. But the only way you're going to be able to do that is if you're disciplined by doing the things you say you're going to do. See, it's really easy. When you hear this, a lot of you guys are like, dude, I'm going to do this. I'm going to time block. 8 o'clock, I'm doing this. 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock, I'm doing this. I'm doing this. I'm doing this. If I do this every single day, I know for a fact I'm going to make millions of dollars inside of this business. It's really easy to do day one. You know what? It might be easy to do day two. You might be able to get through a week of it just kicking its ass. But I'm telling you, it's a challenge to stay on top of it for all of us. Life happens. We get sidetracked and it's okay. But when you get sidetracked, you better be jumping right back onto that track. See, a lot of us, when we get sidetracked, we stay off track. You got to learn when you get sidetracked, you got to learn how to get back on track as fast as you possibly can. That goes back with number four, being consistent. That explains itself. So I'm not going to dive in deeper into that. Number five, I'm going to talk about this. Pretty powerful. Find a mentor. Seek advice. Something I've always been very good at is I've been very good at weaseling my way in at the top. Build relationships with people that are better than you. I'm sure we've all heard you're the average of the five people you surround yourself with. That's no secret. I think that's pretty obvious. However, a lot of us know that, but who are you still hanging out with? Let's be real. We all know this. You're the average of the five people you surround yourself with. Who are you still hanging out with? I'm not telling you got to drop your friends. However, I am saying you need to give some people in your life a little bit less real estate inside of your life. You've got to find better people to surround yourself with, because you are, in fact, the average of the people you surround yourself with. Without a doubt, not one of you guys can rebuttal that. I promise you, you're the average of the people you surround yourself with. And not just the people you surround yourself with, you are the average of the books you read, you are the average of the movies, the TV shows you watch, you are the average of everything that you do. So you need to pay attention to who you are surrounding yourself with. If you want to be successful in this business, you better build relationships with the top people inside of this business. But by the way, the top people inside of this business are not just going to become your friends because you want to become friends with them. You have to earn their respect. And you earn their respect by doing the things that they coach you to do. Eric talks about this all the time. You have to be coachable, you have to be willing, and you have to be hungry. He said, Miles, if somebody that you're working with is missing one of those three, you got to give them the boot. They're going to have to figure it out on their own. Coachable, willing, hungry. You do those things, then your leadership will want to work with you. Number eight, gratitude, serve, believe. Two quotes that I've lived my whole life off of. My mom said one, my dad said the other. What's really cool is I was very blessed to grow up in a successful family. But what was crazy is I grew up in a very successful family. However, I never knew who John Maxwell was. I didn't know who Tony Robbins was. I didn't know anybody, Jim Rohn. I mean, I literally did not know anybody at all from a coaching standpoint, like at all. However, I have heard almost everything there is to hear through my parents. I know a lot of you guys, you have kids. There's nothing more powerful for a parent to do for their child than for their child to watch them work for something, fight for something, struggle for something, and succeed with that something. Nothing more powerful than that. So remember, as a parent, I'm not trying to give parenting advice. However, remember, as a parent, your kids are watching everything that you do. They're watching your attitude whenever things are tough. They're watching your attitude when things are great. They're watching how you handle things. They're watching how you work towards things. Remember, quitting is a habit. You start quitting on things, your kids are going to start quitting on things. You don't want your kids to be quitters. You know that. Keep that in mind. I know I'm not trying to give parenting advice. However, it's the truth. And I think there's so much when it comes to network marketing. But one of my favorite things in the world about network marketing is the fact that my daughter gets to watch me and my wife kick ass in this industry. She gets to see us on stage. She gets to come on stage with us. She's 4.5 years old. She's already coming on stage with us. Like, It's my favorite thing in the world about this industry is being able to see my baby girl. There's a video. My wife, she's actually on stage, and me and my daughter, I think she was probably 3 at the time, we're up at the front of the stage. We're actually sitting on the floor, and she's just sitting there watching her mom on stage. And there's a video of it. There's a picture of it. And it is one of my most precious freaking things in the world. Just seeing her life. And you know what she said to me? She goes, daddy, mommy's a princess. Like, get out of here. You know what I mean? Like, it was like the way she said it was just so freaking beautiful. Anyways, beside the point, moving on. But be grateful for what you have. Be grateful. Everything happens for a reason. Struggle happens for a reason. Everything has purpose. I don't know your religious beliefs. I don't know where your faith stands, but I promise you, everything happens for a reason. The worst times in your life are going to bring some sort of purpose into your life. I promise you. So be grateful for the things that you wouldn't even think to be grateful for. Be grateful. Serve. If you want to be successful in network marketing, you better be good at serving. Who's the number one network marketer to ever live? Not trying to get religious on you guys, but the number one network marketer ever is Jesus Christ. Why was that? Why is he the number one network marketer? He has the biggest following of any human on earth. And did you know he only had 12 disciples? See, a lot of people think, oh my gosh, if I want to be successful, I have to, you know, build with thousands of thousands of people. By the way, my team, I have tens of thousands of people inside of my organization, but I have a small few that I work with, that I communicate with, that I work through every single day. Those are the 12 disciples, right? You don't have to work with the world, but you know what you do have to do as a leader? You have to serve. See, in this industry, your downline, they have to respect you. They have to like you. They have to love you if they're going to be making you money. Now, if you're not likable, lovable, and you don't care, and you don't serve your team, you're not going to be successful here. And if you are, it's not going to last very long. People do business with people that they know, like, and trust. If they don't like you, they don't trust you, you're not going to have a business very long. It's a matter of time before you're out. So you've got to serve. You got to serve your team. And that's something too. And I think Marcus, you know, he kind of alluded to this. He kind of talked about this. You know, he was with the company that I was with, and, you know, he left. Like, listen, I don't care. Not every company is for everybody. I want him to be successful no matter freaking what, no matter what it is with, no matter what. I want him to win. I want him to succeed. He is my friend. I am rooting for him always. I don't care where he's at. I'm always going to have his back. Why? Because I promise you, me and Marcus are going to be brothers for life, and we're going to be doing business, whether no matter where it's at, sooner or later down the road. Dude, this is how this business works. It's how this industry works, whether it's network marketing or something completely not network marketing. But again, most people, he said it, most people are, oh, you're going to quit, get away. Like, you're shunned, we're not friends. You know, in fact, most of the time I've seen it a million times inside of this industry, now it's war. Now you're battling. You know, you're talking shit back and forth, you're making up rumors. Like, it's just stupid, absolutely stupid. I want Marcus to win. I want all of you guys to win. You're not in my company. I have absolutely nothing to do with y'all's success. But I want you to win so freaking bad because, for one, I love the industry, and I think this industry needs a shift in perspective. I think it needs a shift into not just teams wanting each other to win, but I've seen companies to where one team is battling against the other team. The company's not going to grow if each team is fighting against each other. What if the whole industry came together? You know what I mean? So that's my belief. But again, it still starts with being a servant leader. If you want to be successful, you got to look out for your team. The person that wins the most is the person that cares the most about their team and their team's success, not their own success. If you want to win, you help your team win. Personal development, y'all, man, I hope this is, I don't know how often y'all have training calls, but if this is like, let's just say, for instance, this is y'all's once a week training call. If y'all are relying on this once a week training call to grow like you're dropping the ball, man. You need to be doing personal development every single freaking day. You need to be studying the elites. You need to be studying the top. You need to be studying the entrepreneurs. You need to be studying mindset. Like, you need to be growing every single day. I will tell you, there's one audio that if I can encourage you, I would imagine most of you guys have listened to this probably more than once, okay? Building Your Network Marketing Business by Jim Rohn, okay? Now, you may or may not have listened to that. I promise you, it's 1 hour. Listen, if you're ever wondering, what should I listen to today? What should I watch? Should I get on YouTube? What should I read? Listen, if you're ever struggling with what to do, just listen to that audio. I can literally recite the entire audio, and still every single time I listen to it, which I listen to it a minimum of once a month because it is the best. But every single time, I can recite the whole thing, but every time something clicks a little bit different, the light bulb goes off a little bit different. Every single time I learn something new from something I've heard thousands of times. By the way, if you've been on presentations, you've been on trainings, and you're like, oh, it's the same thing over and over. I'm not going to hop on this one. I'm not going to hop on that one. You're dropping the ball, because you know what? That might be the one training. That might be the one presentation where something clicks just a little bit different that takes your whole business to a whole nother level. See, it's the small things. It's the small things that are going to change your life. It's the small things that are going to make you successful. Check this out. One of my favorite quotes I've ever heard. If you are too big to do the small things, you are too small to cash the big checks. It's all the small things, they add up. Always do one more. Always do one more. If you say, I'm going to make 10 phone calls today, make 11. If you say, I'm going to talk to 15 people today, make it 16. If you're like, I'm going to get one enrollment today, make it 2 enrollments. Always do one more, even when you're in the gym. And I'm not talking about just in this business. I'm talking about everything in life. Y'all, you have to become a better you. You have to become a better you. It's not hard, y'all. This industry is not hard. You just got to be the best version of yourself. And you got to work every single day at doing that, because the better you are at being you, the best version of you, your business is going to grow organically. It's simple things that can change your life. Waking up when your alarm clock goes off, not hitting the snooze button, making your bed every single day. It's small stuff, man. I know it sounds super, super cheesy, but y'all, I am telling you, if you start waking up when your alarm clock goes off, because here's the thing, your day is based off of victories. It's all, everything's based off of momentum. Momentum, you're either growing in momentum or you're falling in momentum. Like it's one or the other. You have to kick the ball uphill every single day, because truth be told, the ball rolls faster downhill than it goes uphill. Every single thing you do in life, y'all, is one step forward, two steps backwards. See, a lot of you guys are coasting. You can't coast. If you're coasting, you're going backwards. Everything, one step forward, two steps back. Kick the ball forward every single day. You have to. And when you're talking about momentum in a day, the alarm goes off, you hit your snooze button, you start your day off with a failure. You don't make your bed, that's your second failure. Two failures before you even got out of the bedroom, before you even got dressed. Now you go the other way, get up when the alarm clock goes off, you make your bed as soon as you get out of the bed. Now you've started your day with two victories. Your next one's going to be an easier victory. Next thing you know, you're going to bed at night saying, dude, today I kicked today's ass, baby, let's go. No better feeling than that right there. All right, so have goals. If you don't have goals, if you don't have targets, you're never going to hit the bullseye. I'm not going to dive too deep into that. I think this is pretty obvious. If you don't have clear goals, what are you shooting for? You have no direction. You're just shooting in the wind. You cannot play life by chance. And take responsibility. Stop pawning it off on your upline, your downline. Oh, my downline's not doing anything. Man, I get this all the time. So many people come to me all across this industry, say, you know, Miles, I got a question for you. And I coach everybody, by the way. You don't see me super active on social media. You don't see me super active like, you know, a lot of people personally. It's just not my thing. I just want to build. I want to be in the trenches, and I just want to help people. I want to love people. I don't have coaching courses, anything, but I tell you what, you shoot me a message, I'm going to give you my advice. And I have people always say, man, what do I do if my team's not doing anything? honestly, if your team's not doing anything, first thing you need to do is ask yourself why. Because the team, the speed of the team is the speed of the leader. You need to look yourself in the face, in the mirror, and ask yourself, is my team not doing anything because I'm not the best leader? Or is my team not doing anything because they're just not doing anything? Like, regardless, it doesn't matter. Now, if you're right, maybe you are working hard. Maybe you are a great leader. Maybe your team, guys, here's the statistics, okay? So this is all comes from Eric Worre. 2 out of 100 people, 2 out of 100 are going to be rock stars. 2 out of 100, okay? So you need to keep in mind, if people are not going to do the business. They're going to sit around. They're going to play the business. They're going to pretend they're doing the business. A lot of you guys, I'm going to be real. I hope I can be blunt with you guys. A lot of you guys are pretending to do the business. You're showing up to the calls. You're showing up to the trainings. You're showing up, but you're not actually doing what you know you need to do. You're just showing, you're pretending to do the business, which is fine. Like, I'm not dogging that. Maybe you're here because you love the community. Fantastic. That's good. However, if you want to be successful, you got to do what you're supposed to do. Now, but I get people all the time, what do I do if my team's not doing anything? First off, what you need to do if your team's not doing anything, you need to find a new team. You need to get in the trenches. You need to start recruiting. There's nothing that 20 new business partners cannot fix. Eric Worre says it all the time. Some of you guys might be saying, wow, 20 people, that's a lot. Some of you guys also are saying 20 people, that's not much. What side of the fence are you on? Confidence, conviction, I already talked about. Last thing I want to talk about is just simply caring. The people that win here are the people that care the most. They care about their business. They care about their team. They care about the success. They care about the calls. They care about the prospects. They just simply care more. And I know, Marcus, my man, you wanted me to talk a little bit about duplication. You wanted me to talk about, building internationally. And I'll tell you, it all starts with this. It's all basics. There's no secret to building international. There's no secret to duplication. The secret to duplication is everything that I just shared with you, making sure your team knows all this stuff. This is duplication. If your team is doing all the things that I'm teaching here, your team's going to duplicate. You're going to duplicate. You're going to hit the next rank. You're going to fly through the ranks as long as your team is doing this. Now, are you good at plugging your team in? Are you taking care of your team? Y'all, this business is not hard. It's really not. It's not rocket science. In fact, this business probably is the most simple business model on the planet. However, it doesn't make it easy. Got to get out of your comfort zone. And if you want to build international, man, you got to build relationships. Somebody that you know knows somebody that is international. You got to recruit them. You got to build them. And by the way, when you have rock stars join your organization, a lot of you guys, I'm just going to be straight with you. A lot of you guys, y'all have somebody right now currently in your business that is an absolute freaking rock star, but you're dropping the ball as a leader. And that might not be easy to say, but some of you guys, you know what? Some of you guys lost rock stars inside of your organization because you just were not necessarily prepared for them. A lot of you guys are hoping for the rock star. Truth be told, the rock star comes into your organization. It doesn't matter if you're not prepared for the rock star. You have to be all of these things that I talked about today. You got to do all of these things, not just one pillar. You got to do all the pillars. Everything that I talked about. Focus on 5 things: faith, family, friends, fitness, finances. Focus on these things, your life will grow. Be intentional with everything that you do. Y'all, I am so happy to be on here. I hope you guys got some value. If y'all don't know who I am, y'all can follow me on Instagram, shoot me messages and stuff. Instagram is definitely the easiest way to get a hold of me, more so than anything else. So always here for you guys, always here to coach. You can see my handle as well in the chat. But I want to coach you. I want to help you. Man, I want you to win. I absolutely want you to win. Marcus, my man, I got your back always, brother. I hope you guys absolutely crush this thing. Take this whole industry to a whole nother level. Thank y'all so much for being on. And I know I went for a very long time because the call was like an hour. And Marcus, I think he said like 5-10 minutes. So I told you, man, I go for a long time. So y'all have a great night. Hey, 54 people held on. So I'm glad y'all did. God bless. Y'all have a fantastic rest of y'all's evening. Have a great weekend. And let's all change this industry, turn it into the best. It is the best industry, but let's make sure the world knows that it is the best industry in the world. So thank y'all so much, Marcus. I'm going to go ahead and pass it back to you, my man.
drop a value in the chat. If you got some value tonight, drop some value in the chat with some extra, what they call it? Exclamation point. Value, value, value. Man, he brought that, man. I hope all y'all took notes. I got my notes here, man. I thought I knew a little bit. Come to find out, I got a lot more learning to do. Get out of your comfort zone. Stop procrastination. Have a DMO. Be consistent. Find a mentor. Find a mentor. You know why Danielson, how many of y'all seen Karate Kid? You know why Danielson was so good at throwing that punch and kicking that foot? Because he had Mr. Miyagi. Who would Danielson have been if it was not Mr. Miyagi? So I want to definitely give it back up to Miles Stellar, man. Miles, man, you brought the fire tonight. You definitely exceeded pretty much everyone's expectations. Mine definitely, I'm definitely going to be hitting you up. I'm sure we're going to have people on the team hitting you up just for the mentorship. So I hope you don't get too many DMs. And I definitely want to, before we end the call tonight, because I know we went over, and I know y'all like, dang, it's Friday night. We were going to do a Q&A session, but it kind of went too long, and I do apologize for that, because I know some of y'all got some questions. But I do want to bring up to everyone that on Monday, we do have our motivational call every Monday. Motivation call, motivation is key. And before we end the call, we will end with one of my favorite quotes. It is crowded at the bottom, but there is plenty of opportunities available at the top. With that being said, I hope you guys have a great weekend. See you at the top.